稍等一下，稍等一下，我Hare Krishna，啊不，抱歉，我刚才授权案件按错了。
Hare Krishna，顶拜大家，顶拜 Guru Maharaj Hare Krishna。
Recording in progress。
好的，可以开始了。
Om Jnana Tamarandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militanyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschacha Deshatarine Vanchakalpatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhubhayeva cha Patitanam Pavanibhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. We're reading the sixth canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam, and we're on chapter number 12, entitled Vritasura's Glorious Death.
We're learning the Srimad Bhagavatam, the sixth canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam, the title is Vritasura's Glorious Death.
So Vritasura was the leader of the army of the demons who were fighting against the demigods who were led by Indra. Indra was armed with a weapon made from the bones of a great yogi named Adichie.
Indra 他带了一个他自己的武器，那个武器是由打地气的骨头做成的。
And he was told by Lord Narayan to get those bones and to make a weapon which could kill Vritasura.
而且主哪央呢告诉他用这个骨头去做一个武器，用这个武器去和维彻苏惹作战。
And Vritasura is very powerful. He has a huge body, and he was so powerful that he was able to injure Indra, knock a weapon out of his hands, and knock back Indra's elephant many yards.
维彻苏惹是如此的强大有力，而且他的身躯巨大。他甚至能把 Indra 所有的武器都给驳回去，甚至把 Indra 的坐骑 Aravata 的这个大象给他击退了14马。
Vritasura was encouraging Indra to use his weapon to kill him.
Vritasura 也在鼓励 Indra 运用他的武器去杀掉 Vritasura 自己。
But Indra was reluctant to do that because he knew that Vritasura was a great devotee.
Indra 这个时候就有点犹豫，他因为他已经发觉 Vritasura 他是一个奉献者。
Although he was in a demon's body, he was actually a great devotee.
即便他有一个恶魔的躯体，但是他实际上是一个伟大的奉献者。
Vritasura was encouraging Indra that if you kill me, you know, it's good for me, because Vritasura knew if he's killed, and then he was going to go back to Godhead.
Vritasura 一直在鼓励 Indra, 他希望 Indra 能够杀掉自己，因为他知道如果自己能够被杀的话，他就能够立即回归守神。
And Vritasura is eager to go back to Godhead, but Indra, his interest is to win the battle, because if he wins the battle, then he will remain king of heaven.
Vritasura 是非常渴望想回到守神那里去的，但是 Indra 的他的兴趣就是他希望能够在这场战争中赢得胜利，而且夺回天地，夺回这个天堂王国。
So at one point in the battle, Indra used his weapon and he cut off the arm of Vritasura.
在之前，因着运用这个PD 的武器，把Vritasura的臂膀给砍了下来。
But Vritasura was not disturbed. He continued to go forward in battle to face Indra.
即便这样，Vritasura他也没有受到任何的打扰，他继续和Indra直面的勇敢去作战。
And in the course of fighting, Vritasura is speaking philosophy about Bhakti Yoga to Indra.
在这个打仗的过程中，为了增加这个战斗，让这个战斗继续下去 ，Vritasura 甚至给 Indra 讲了 Bhakti Yoga 的哲学。
So we're reading from text number 14, chapter 12.
我们现在正在是第六章第十二第六篇第十二章的第十四十节。
Yeah. So Vritasura is speaking to Indra, and he tells Indra that everything is dependent on the supreme will of the personality of Godhead.
Vritasura 这个时候就在教导 Indra， 一切其实都仰赖于至尊人格守神至高无上的意志。
And so we should not get disturbed by fame or getting, if we have a good name or a bad name, it shouldn't disturb us.
那么如果是这样的话，人就不应该在很好的名誉或者说受到诽谤的时候受到打扰。
We should remain undisturbed, whether we win or we lose, and whether we live or we die.
无论我们是在胜利还是失败，无论我们是在活着还是死亡，我们都应该不受打扰。
Right. So these different situations indicate some kind of happiness and distress.
这样，以快乐为痛苦的这些结果之中。
But we should always remain steady. We shouldn't have any anxiety, and we should keep our mind controlled.
无论这个结果是快乐还是痛苦，我们都应该保持平静，远离焦虑，控制自己的心意。
Vritasura continues speaking. He said, one should know the three qualities: goodness, passion, and ignorance. We should know that these are not actually qualities of the soul, but these are qualities of the material nature.
Vritasura 继续说。人应该了解善良属性、激情属性、愚昧属性，这三种品质实际上不是灵魂的品质，而是物质自然的品质。
So, if somebody knows that the soul is simply a witness to the actions and reactions, then he's a liberated person.
如果一个人了解灵魂他只是这些活动的观察者，那么这样的一个人，他可以被称为是一个解脱了的人。
He's not controlled by these qualities.
而且他也不被这些品质所控制、所束缚。
So this is described also in the Bhagavad Gita.
这个在博迦梵歌中也有描述。
Krishna says, if we are transcendentally situated, then we'll be joyful.
Krishna 说，如果我们能够处在超然的境界之中，那么我们就会感受到愉悦。
We won't lament, and we won't desire to have anything.
我们既不悲伤，也不渴求得到什么。
We'll be equal to everyone.
我们会对所有的一切一视同仁。
So in that way, we will get pure devotional service.
在这种状态下，我们就能达到纯粹奉献服务的境界。
So when we become self-realized, then we'll be at the Brahma-Buddha stage.
当一个人处于觉悟自我的阶段的时候，他属于 Brahma-Buddha 的阶段。
Brahma-Buddha means to know that we're not the body, that we're Brahman.
Brahma Buddha 的意思是我们知道我们不是这个躯体，我们是梵。
So, in that condition, we know that whatever happens during this life, it is due to the contamination of the modes of nature.
在 Brahma Buddha 阶段，人知道一切都其实来，就是生命中所发生的一切，其实都是物质自然的污染。
But the pure soul, the living being, the pure soul has nothing to do with the material nature.
但是生物体纯粹的灵魂和这个物质自然没有什么关系。
Yeah, he's nothing to do with the three modes. He's transcendental to the modes.
他和物质自然三属性没有什么关系，他超然于三属性之上。
So the material world.Sometimes it's like being in a hurricane because everything can change very quickly.
物质世界就好比在飓风之中，因为一切都在变化得非常快。
But if that person can remain silent and simply look and watch the actions and the reactions, then he's a liberated soul.
虽然世界在变换，但如果一个人他能够保持沉默，保持缄默，去观察这些活动和活动的反应，这样他便被理解为是解脱了的。
So the real qualification of a liberated soul is that he will remain Krishna conscious.
一个解脱的灵魂，他真正的品质就是他恒常的保持 Krishna 知觉。
He won't be disturbed by the actions and the reactions of the material energy.
他不会被物质的各种各样的能量所打扰。
So such a person, that liberated person, is very joyful.
而这样一位解脱的灵魂，他也是非常的愉悦和喜乐的。
He never laments and he never desires for anything.
他既不悲伤也不渴求任何的事情。
Everything is supplied by the Supreme Lord.
一切都是由至尊主所提供着。
So the living being, living entities, they just depend on the Supreme Lord.
所以个体生物它只是依靠着主。
So they don't protest.They won't complain, they won't protest, I don't have enough.
这样的个体，他如果明白这一点，他也不会有任何的抱怨和抗议，说，哦，我现在没有什么东西。
我现在没有，我的东西不够。
对，他不会抱怨说我的东西不够，不足够。
And he won't accept anything for his own sense gratification.
他也不会接受任何的什么事情作为他自己个人的感官享乐。
He'll receive everything as the mercy of Krishna.
他把一切都当作至尊主 Krishna 的仁慈来接受。
And he'll be steady in all situations.
他会在任何的情况下保持稳定。
So Vritasura says to Indra, he says, just look at me. I've already been defeated.
维彻苏热跟英哲说：“你看看我吧，我现在已经被打败了。
My weapon and my arm have been cut to pieces.
我的武器、我的臂膀都已经被切碎了。
You've already overwhelmed me.
你已经征服我了。
But with I still have a desire to kill you. I'm trying my best to fight.”
但是尽管我现在这样，我想杀死你的心，我想战斗的心还是没有停止。
I'm not disappointed even under these conditions.
我在这种处境下，我一点都不沮丧。
So you should give up your disappointment and your sadness, and you should keep fighting.
因此你也应该放弃你的沮丧郁闷继续战斗。
So Vritasura was a very great and powerful fighter.
Vritrasura 是一个非常有力量的 战士。
And he was actually acting by his talking, he was acting like the spiritual master of Indra.
他这个时候实际上扮演着 Indra 的离性导师。
Vritrasura was just about defeated, but he wasn't affected.
Vritrasura, 处在失败的边缘，但是他并不受打扰。
He knew he was going to be defeated by Indra.
而且他也知道他即将被 Indra 打败。
And he accepted that.
他接受这个结果。
But he was supposed to be Indra's enemy.
但是他应该成为 Indra 的敌人。
So he tried his best to kill Indra.
作为 Indra 的敌人，他就会尽最大的努力去杀死 Indra。
So this was his duty. Actually, he'd taken birth. His father had done the yagya to get a son who would be Indra's enemy.
这就是他自己的职责。事实上，他的父亲创造他做这个祭祀，创造他的时候，造就了他成为 Indra 的敌人。
But he did the yagya wrong. Actually, he wanted somebody who was going to kill Indra, but he only got somebody who was the enemy of Indra.
他的父亲实际上是想创造一个能够杀死 Indra 的人，但是他由于在做祭祀过程中出现了一点小小的失误，造成了他创造了一个只是 Indra 的敌人的这么一个人。
So everyone should do their duty in under all circumstances.
无论如何，每一个人都应该去在任何情况下都恪守自己的职责。
Even though you may know what the result is, still you have to do your duty.
即便你知道你做这件事情的结果是什么，但是你仍然应该履行你该做的职责。
So Vritrasura says to Indra, he says,Consider this battle a gambling match.
Vritrasura 跟 Indra 说，把这场战斗看作是一场赌局。
And the stakes for this gambling match are our lives. We have to bet our lives.
是我们的，把我们的生命看作是赌注。
And the arrows are like the dice.
把剑作为骰子。
And the animals, which are our carriers, they're like the game board.
我们的坐骑，我们的动物坐骑，视为这个赌桌。
Right, Indra had a carrier, an elephant carrier.
Indra 有一个大象的坐骑。
I don't know what kind of type of carrier Vritrasura had, but anyway.No, then Vritrasura, no one can understand who will be defeated and who will win.
没有人知道谁会被打败，谁会胜利。
It all depends on providence.
一切都仰赖于天意。
Providence, that the gopis sing about that in the 10th canto andIn the Srimad Bhagavatam, the gopis sing, they say, Providence, you're cruel to us.
木牛姑娘在第十篇的时候说了这一席类似的话，就是说天意就让你非常残忍地对待我们。
Providence, we could also say destiny, or you could call it karma also, you know, it depends, it's not really in our hands, but it's all arranged.
这个天意也可以理解为说是命中注定，就是说一切不在我们的掌握之中，一切都是命中注定的。
So Sukadeva Goswami says, Sukadeva Goswami, he's narrating this pastime to Maharaj Parikshit, and he says that King Indra.Has been hearing the instructions of Vritrasura.
Shukadeva Goswami 这个时候就开始说了，因为这Shukadeva Goswami 正在给 Maharaj Parikshit 复述这个小月时光，所以他说，当 Indra 听到 Vritrasura 的这一番话之后。
So after he heard Vritrasura's words, then Indra again picked up the thunderbolt weapon in his hand because he dropped it. But Vritrasura, don't pick it up. Go ahead, pick it up. You can use it to kill me.
因为Indra 之前他的霹雳被击掉了，就是掉落在地上了。他听到了 Vritrasura 这席之话之后，他就开始捡起了他的霹雳。
Yeah, he dropped it when Vritrasura attacked. So Vritrasura had knocked the weapon from his hand, but then Vritrasura allowed him to pick it up. He wants him to use it to fight because he knows that weapon is going to kill him.
Indra 和 Vritrasura 之前的战斗之中 ，Indra 的这个霹雳掉在地上，但是 Vritrasura 一直鼓励他。拿起你的霹雳，于是 Indra 这个时候开始拿起了霹雳，继续准备和 Vritrasura 作战。
So Indra smiled, and then he's going to speak to Vritrasura.
Indra 这个时候也笑了，他准备对 Vritrasura 说一段话。
He appreciates Vritrasura. He knows Vritrasura is a great devotee. He's a better devotee than Indra.
He 非常欣赏 Vritrasura, 而且他也知道 Vritrasura 是一个伟大的奉献者，甚至比他自己都要好。
So King Indra, he's the greatest of the demigods, but he was shocked to hear Vritrasura speak all these words.
Indra 是最伟大的半神，但是当他听到 Vritrasura 这一番话之后，他被他的这一番话感到震惊。
Yeah, Vritrasura was supposed to be a demon, but he had so much devotion.
Vritrasura 本应该是一个恶魔，但是他竟然有如此多的奉爱之情。
So Indra was surprised that a demon could speak with so much.Knowledge and intelligence.
Indra 对 Vritrasura 这样一个恶魔能说出如此有智慧、有知识的话，感到非常的惊讶。
But then Indra remembered other devotees like Prahlad Maharaj and Bali Maharaj, who had also been born in a family of demons.
Indra 随后也想起了像巴利马哈拉吉、普拉德马哈拉吉，他们也是来自于恶魔家庭。
So even some demons, sometimes they have so much devotion for Krishna.
因此，即便有的时候有一些人是恶魔，但是他仍然对主 Krishna 有很多的奉爱之情。
So Indra smiles at Vritrasura, thinking about how great devotee he is.
所以 Indra 就朝着 Vritrasura 笑一笑，他对他的奉爱之情感到惊讶。
So Indra is going to reply to the words of Vritrasura. Vritrasura had been preaching to Indra. Now Indra is going to reply, and he says to Vritrasura, "O great demon, I see by your discrimination, you know, your ability to distinguish between one thing and another. I see your discrimination and your endurance. Endurance means like determination to stay in devotional service.
在先前 Vritrasura 在给 Indra 讲述了很多奉献，讲述了很多的教导。这个时候 Indra 就开始回复 Vritrasura。Indra 说道，伟大的恶魔啊，我现在已经能感受到你非常好的分辨能力和你的决心忍耐力。
And even though you're in a dangerous position, I can see that you're a great devotee, a perfect devotee of the Supreme Lord.
即便你处在危难的关头，但是我仍然发现您是至尊主的一个伟大的奉献者。
And the Supreme Lord is the super soul and the friend of everyone.
至尊主他是超灵，他也是众生的朋友。
So Prabhupada quotes for us from the Bhagavad Gita 6th chapter that when a person is in Krishna consciousness, then we never go away from the truth.
圣帕帕德引述了《薄伽梵歌》中第六章二十二节中所说的，当一个人处在 Krishna 知觉之中，他再也不会偏离。
And when we get Krishna consciousness, then we know that there's no better thing, there's no greater thing we could get.
当一个人如果真正得到 Krishna 知觉，他就会发现再也没有比 Krishna 知觉更好的东西了。
And when we're in that position, we never get disturbed, we never become anxious or in anxiety, even in the greatest difficulty.
当一个人得到这样的 Krishna 知觉，他再也不会被打扰，他再也，即便在任何样的处境下，他也不会动摇。
A pure devotee is never disturbed by any kind of difficulties.
一位纯洁无瑕的奉献者不会被任何种类的困难处境所打扰。
Indra was surprised. He wasn't in any anxiety at all.
Indra 非常惊讶地看到 Vitrasura 竟然毫不动摇，他一点都不焦虑。
And he was very fixed in his devotional service to Krishna.
而且他非常稳定地、坚定地处在对 Krishna 的奉献服务之中。
So that's very unusual for a demon to be in that position.
因此，一个恶魔处在这样的处境下是非常不寻常的一件事情。
But by the grace of the Supreme Lord, anyone can become a great devotee.
然而，凭借至尊主的仁慈，任何人都能够成为非常崇高的奉献者。
Bhagavad Gita says, even we be of low birth, like women or sudras or vaishyas, we can all approach the supreme destination.
主在《薄伽梵歌》中也证实了，即便我们处在很低等的出身，比如说 vaishya sudra。包括女人的出身，即便我们出身非常的低阶层，但是仍然我们可以做奉献服务，可以回归圣人。
A pure devotee is sure to go back to Godhead.
纯洁无瑕的奉献者一定能够回归圣人。
So Indra tells Vritasura, "You've already crossed over the illusory energy of Lord Vishnu."You've crossed over.
Indra 对 Vitrasura 说，你已经征服了至尊主的虚幻能量。
And because you're liberated, you have given up the mood of the demon.
由于你的这种解脱，你已经放弃了恶魔的心态。
And instead, you're now in the position of a great devotee.
换而言之，你已经成为了一位非常崇高的奉献者。
So Lord Vishnu, he is the Mahapurusha, the great soul. He is the great soul.
主 Vishnu 是 Mahapurusha, 最伟大的灵魂。
Anyone who becomes a Vaishnava gets the position.They get the position of being a Mahapurusha.
因而任何成为 Vaishnava 的人，他都能达到 Mahapurusha 的地位。
Just like Maharaj Parikshit, he got that position.
就像 Maharaj Parikshit, 他也达到了这个地位。
Yeah. Lord Vishnu is a Mahapurush, but this is a Mahapurushaya. So it's a difference. It's not that you're equal to Mahavishnu.But, right? There's the Mahapurush, is Lord Vishnu, and the Mahapurushaya is the living entities, the great devotees.
主威士努被称为 Mahapurusha， 然后主威士努的奉献者，这些伟大的奉献者被称为 Mahapurushaya， 这个代表的是这些伟大奉献者的地位。
So Maharaj Parikshit was a Mahapurusha, and it's stated in the Padma Purana that there's a difference between the demigods and a demon.
Maharaj Parikshit, he attained the Mahapurushaya position. Then, in Padma Purana, it describes the difference between the demigods and
the demon. And the difference is that the demigod is a devotee of Lord Vishnu, but the demons are not.
区别是半神人是主威士努的奉献者，而恶魔却不是。
So Vritasura was considered a demon, but actually he was more qualified as a devotee. He was more qualified as a devotee. He was a Mahapurusha. He was a great devotee.
Vritasura 被认为是恶魔，但是事实上他应该是一位奉献者，而且是一位非常伟大的奉献者 ，Mahapurusha。
So if someone becomes a devotee of the Supreme Lord, it doesn't matter what position he's in, he can come to that position of a perfect person.
如果一个人不知怎的成为至尊主的奉献者，那么无论他之前的地位如何，他都将被成。
So this is possible if a pure devotee tries to serve the Lord.
这个是可能的，如果一位纯粹奉献者在努力地服务主。
He just has to try to, if the devotee tries to deliver the devotee in this way.A devotee wants to deliver the sinful people.
如果一个服务主的纯粹奉献者，他在拯救这个罪恶的人的话。
Yeah, he's trying to serve the Lord by delivering the fallen souls to Krishna consciousness.
他通过拯救这样堕落的灵魂去服务至尊主。
So there's this famous verse which is given in the second canto, in the fourth chapter.
有一个非常有名的诗节，这也论述到了这一点，在圣典波迦瓦坛的第二篇的第四章。
It's spoken by Sukadeva Goswami when the time when Sukadeva Goswami is offering prayers to the Supreme Lord.
这个也是 Sukadeva Goswami 向至尊主所供奉的祷文。
Now, Sukadeva Goswami is asked, he's been asked questions by Maharaj Parikshit about the creation. So he's describing, before he answers the questions about creation, he offers prayers.
那个时候 Sukadeva Goswami 被 Maharaj Parikshit 在问 Sukadeva Goswami 有关于创造的问题。Maharaj就是 Sukadeva Goswami 在回答这个问题之前向至尊主供奉了如下的祷文。
It's a custom. Whenever you have to answer questions and you're going to speak to glorify the Lord, that before we speak, we should first of all offer prayers.
这也是一种习惯。当我们在回答问题或者说在当我们在回答问题或讲述某些话题之前，我们通常向至尊主供奉祷文。
And in the prayers, we offer our respects to the Supreme Lord, and we request Him to please bless us that we can speak something which will be pleasing to Him.
在这个祷文之中，我们荣耀主，然后我们请求主能够让我们说一些话，能够取悦主。
And here in this particular verse, Sukadeva Goswami prays that even sinful people people of different sinful races, they can all be delivered by taking shelter of the devotees.
在这节特别的诗中描述到，任何罪就是处在任何就是任何一个沉溺于罪恶活动的人，都可以通过托庇于至尊主的奉献者而得到拯救。
So this is the power of the Lord's devotees that they can give us, even though we may come from sinful backgrounds, the great devotees, they can give us shelter and purify us.
这里是描述了至尊主的奉献者的力量，就是无论我们处在什么样的罪恶的情况，或者说怎么样的背景，只要我们托庇于至尊主的奉献者，我们都能得到。我们都能得到，也能得到至尊主的庇护，得到至高无上的，得到至尊主的庇护。
Yeah, if somebody takes shelter of the pure devotee, even though they're of a very low character or come from a sinful background, they can be purified by the mercy of the pure devotee.
只要他托庇于至尊主的奉献者。任何一个罪恶的人都能通过这样的活动得到净化，得到这样奉献者的仁慈得到净化。
Of course, they have to follow the instructions of the pure devotee.
当然，这个托庇者他应该去接受纯粹奉献者的训示和指导。
But it doesn't matter what kind of background they come from, where they took birth, what kind of country or society they're from.But if they take shelter and are sincere and faithful, then they can be purified.
不管他是来自于什么样的背景、什么样的阶层，只要他托庇于这样一位纯粹奉献者，真诚的而且有信心的去托庇于这样的奉献者，他都能够被净化。
And they can come to the position of being a great devotee.
而且他还能够被提升到伟大奉献者的地位的这个层面上。
So Indra said to Virasura, he said, you know, the demons are generally in the mode of passion.
Indra 说，通常恶魔他是处在激情属性的属性的影响之下。
So Indra said, I'm very surprised that although you are a demon,You have the mind, you have the mood of a devotee.
Indra 跟 Vishasura 说，他说，你虽然是一个恶魔，但是你的心态却是一个奉献者的心态。
And you fixed your mind on the Supreme Lord, Vasudeva.
您把你的心意完全专注于主 Vasudeva 的。
And Lord Vasudeva is always in the mode of pure goodness.
而主 Vasudeva 总是处在纯洁的善良属性的层面之上。
So Indra wondered how could Vridasura come to that position of being such a great devotee.
Indra 就非常惊讶 ，Vritrasura 是如何成为这样的一个伟大的奉献者。
Of course, Indra doesn't know about Vritrasura's past life.
当然 ，Indra 他是不知道 Vritrasura 的潜意识的情况。
Indra didn't know what had happened. How in his previous life, Vritrasura was actually Chitraketu.
Indra 不知道 Vritrasura 在他的潜意识实际上是 Chitraketu.
And Chitraketu had been cursed by Parvati, Lord Shiva's wife.
而 Chitraketu 被 Shiva 的老妻子 Parvati 给诅咒了。
So, Indra understood about Prahlad Maharaj. He knew that Prahlad Maharaj had been initiated by Narada Muni.
Indra 他了解 Prahlad Maharaj 的情况，他知道 Prahlad Maharaj 是被 Narada Muni 给启迪的。
So it was possible for him to become a great devotee, even though he was born in a demon family.
所以因此 Prahlad Maharaj 是出生于恶魔家庭，但是他是有可能成为奉献者的。
But Indra couldn't understand about Vritrasura, how he had become such a great devotee.
但是 Indra 他却无法察觉到 Vritrasura 他是怎么样变成一个奉献者的。
He saw Vritrasura was such a great devotee that he could fix his mind on the lotus feet of Krishna without deviation, without the mind wandering away. His mind was very fixed on the lotus feet of the Lord.
Indra 非常惊讶于 Vritrasura 竟然是一位奉献者，而且能够将自己的心意专注于至尊主 Krishna。Vasudeva 的莲花族，而且毫不偏离。
We know it's not easy to fix the mind on one thing. Arjuna couldn't do it.
因为他也知道，将一个心意完全专注在一件事情上是非常难以做到的事情。Arjuna, could not or could do.
Could not.
Arjuna 也不能做到这一点。
In the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna was telling Arjuna to do yoga and control the mind, but Arjuna said, I can't do it. He said, my mind is more restless than the wind.
在薄伽梵歌中，主 Krishna 告诉 Arjuna, 将你的心意专注下来，但是 Arjuna 说，我无法做到，因为我的心比狂风还难以控制。
But here is Vritrasura.He got one arm chopped off, and he's still fighting, and he's still talking about devotion, and don't get disturbed, and don't get anxiety about being defeated.
但是在这里，我们发现 Vritrasura, 他即便一只臂膀都被砍断了，他仍然在战斗，仍然还在讲述着有关奉爱方面的 bhakti, 奉爱服务。
So Indra says to Vritrasura, he said, when a person is fixed,in devotional service to the Supreme Lord, then the Lord of the highest auspiciousness swims in the ocean of nectar. When a person is fixed in devotional service to the Supreme Lord,
当一个人完全专注于对至尊主的奉献服务之中，
then that's very pleasing to the Supreme Lord.
这对至尊主来说也是非常的非常的愉悦的。
In this way, the devotee can swim in the ocean of nectar.
这样一个专注于至尊主奉献服务的人，他在甘露之洋之中畅游。
So Indra says, "What's the use of having a little water in a small ditch? We want a big ocean."
Indra 说，对于这样的奉献者，一个小小的水洼对于他来说有什么用呢？他要的是海洋。
So Vritrasura.Earlier, when he was offering prayers, he had prayed. He said, I don't want any happiness of the heavenly planets, or Brahma Loka, or even Dhruva Loka.
Vritrasura, 在他之前的祈祷文之中，他说过，我并不渴求 Brahma Loka, 也不渴求在 Dhruva Loka 上。
Yeah, this is at the higher plane. And Vritrasura said, I'm certainly not interested in the happiness of Earth or any of the lower planets. I don't want the happiness of the higher planets. So why would I want the happiness of the lower planets?
先前提到的这些星球都是高等的星球。他说，既然我连高等星球上的快乐我都不要，那更不提更就别提这个地球，或者说低还比地球还要低的这些低等星球上的这些快乐。
So this is the determination of a pure devotee.
这是一位纯粹奉献者的决心。
The pure devotee is never attracted to any big position in the material world.
一位纯粹奉献者绝不会被物质世界的任何地位所吸引。
All he wants is to get the association of the Supreme Lord.
他想要的一切都只是和至尊主联谊。
particularly he'd like to get the association of the inhabitants of Vrindavan, like Srimati Radharani and the gopis and Krishna's father and mother, Nanda Maharaj, Mother Yashoda.
他尤其渴望得到文达门的这些居民, 比如说Srimati Radharani, Gopi, 木流姑娘们, Nanda Maharaj, Yashoda, 等等这些人, 得到他们这些纯粹奉献者的利益。
Yeah, and Krishna's friends and Krishna's servants, he wants to associate with all these people.
他希望得到Krishna的朋友们, Krishna的仆人们, 他希望得到这些人的利益。
He wants to associate with, in the beauty of Vrindavan, and with the, in the atmosphere in Krishna, with Krishna in the beauty of Vrindavan.
他希望能够与 Krishna 所在的文达门这美丽的气氛，在这样的环境下联谊。
So that is the greatest, that's the biggest ambition for a devotee of Krishna.
这是一位 Krishna 的奉献者的最高的抱负和雄心。
A devotee may be, he may be, he may want to be in, he may want a position in Vaikuntha. A devotee of Lord Vishnu, that is, a devotee of Lord Vishnu, he may want to get a position in Vaikuntha.
主威神的奉献者也许会渴求Vaikuntha的地位，Vaikuntha-loka的一个地位。
We should understand in Vaikuntha, there are no renunciates, there's no sannyasis. Everybody's a householder there.
我们应该知道, Vaikuntha那里没有弃绝者, 那里全部都是居士。
But they're all pure devotees.
但是那里全部都是纯粹奉献者。
So the people who are devoted to Vishnu, they may want to get a position in Vaikuntha. But a devotee of Krishna, a devotee of Krishna, he never wants to get that. He never wants a position in Vaikuntha.
主威神的奉献者也许会渴求Vaikuntha的一些地位，但是主 Krishna的奉献者从不会渴求Vaikuntha的地位或者设施。
The devotees of Krishna, they want to be able to go back to Goloka Vrindavan and associate with Krishna there.
主 Krishna的奉献者, 他不会去渴求Vaikuntha的东西, 他只想回到 Goloka Vrindavan, 他想和 Krishna在那里。
Because in Goloka Vrindavan, Krishna's performing his eternal pastimes.
因为在 Goloka Vrindavan, 主 Krishna在那里上演永恒的逍遥时光。
So any kind of happiness in the material world is just like water in a ditch.
因此,相比之下, 任何物质的这些快乐, 就好比小沟沟里面的这些水。
But the spiritual happiness is always enjoyed in the spiritual world. That's like the ocean of nectar.
而灵性世界的快乐, 它永恒地存在于灵性世界之中, 而且就像海洋,甘露一样的海洋。
And the devotee wants to swim in that ocean of nectar.
而且奉献者就想在这样的甘露之洋之中畅游。
You cannot swim in the ditch.
我们无法在一个小沟渠里面去游泳。
And the water in the ditch is not going to be like nectar, it will be all dirt.
在那样的小沟沟里面去游泳, 那里面全部都是脏, 那些都是泥巴。
But the spiritual world, that is real happiness, and that the happiness there is like the ocean of nectar.
而在灵性世界, 那里全部都是，那里的快乐就像海洋一样。
And devotees can go and swim in that ocean.
而且奉献者可以在这样的海洋之中畅游。
There are two activities for devotees, which are spiritual. One is swimming, and the other is wrestling.
在灵性世界有两项活动，第一个就是 第一个就是游泳，第二个就是摔跤。
So, in the spiritual world, Krishna likes also swimming and he likes wrestling.
在灵性世界，主 Krishna 也非常喜欢游泳和摔跤。
And we see when Krishna came to the material world, he was enjoying also swimming the Yamuna, and he would wrestle also in Mathura.
我们看到主 Krishna 来到物质世界的时候，他在亚穆纳河游泳，而且他在马图拉去摔跤。
Okay, so Sukadeva Goswami is talking now, and he said Vritasura and King Indra.Had both spoke about devotional service, even though they're on the battlefield.
Sukadeva Goswami 接着就讲了，现在 Indra 和 Vritasura 他们两个人在战场上都开始谈论奉献服务了，即便他们两个人都还在战场上打斗，他们都开始谈论奉献服务了。
So they're both good devotees.
他们都是很好的奉献。
Yes, Indra is a bit attached to being king of heaven. He wants to keep that position.
只是 Indra 他有一些依附于天堂国王天堂的这个天堂，而且他想赢这场战争。
So although Vritasura and Indra are facing each other on the battlefield, and they've been talking about devotional service, they know they have a duty, and their duty is to fight each other. So they began fighting again.
这个时候 ，Indra 和Vritasura 他们俩面对面的谈论着奉献服务，但是同时他们又知道自己还有职责要履行，那个职责就是战争，于是他们又开始作战了。
And both Indra and Vritasura were great fighters, and they were both very strong.
Indra 和 Vritasura 他们都是伟大的战士，非常有力量。
Actually, Vritasura was.Strong enough, he could defeat Indra.
Vritasura 甚至比 Indra 还要有力量，他可以打败 Indra.
So at one point, Vritasura took his iron club, and he whirled it around and aimed it at Indra, and threw it at him with his left hand. Remember, Vritasura only had one hand; it was his left hand. Indra had already cut off his right hand, so he used his left hand.And he threw the club at Indra.
Vritasura 这个时候拿起他的铁棒，旋转着瞄准向 Indra 抛过去，掷过去。因为我们先前讲到Vritasura 他的右手被 Indra 给砍了下来，所以这个时候他只是用他的左手向 Indra 扔去了铁棒。
So Indra has his thunderbolt weapon.The thunderbolt weapon is called Shataparvan.
Indra 用他的霹雳，这个霹雳的名字叫 Shataparvan.
And Shataparvan means it has 100 joints.
Shataparvan 意味着，这个词意味着有100个关节。
So with that weapon, Indra.Cut to pieces Vritasura's club, and he also cut off his other left, that left hand, the remaining hand.
Indra, 当用这个霹雳的时候，就把 Vritasura 的铁棒和他的另外一只手剁成了碎片。
So Vritasura had now both his arms have been cut off at the root.
Vritasura 这个时候的两只手都被砍断了。
So his arms were bleeding. There was a lot of blood flowing out from the arms because he'd been cut off.
由于他两只手被砍断了，所以这个时候他全部身上流淌了很多的血。
But still, Vritasura looked very beautiful. He was like a flying mountain.
即便这样 ，Vritasura 看上去也非常美丽，像一座飞翔的山脉一样。
Right. In China, we know they have sometimes we saw places where the mountains had previously been flying.
在以前有一些山脉它是好像是可以飞翔的。
Yeah, I think sometimes like Guilin, The mountains there, they look like they came flying in, you know, there's the land is flat all around. And then all of a sudden there'll be a mountain there, or a hill in the middle of the field. And how did it get there? You can just imagine, it must have flown somewhere and just landed there.
就像在中国的桂林，有一些山，它是突然就在一片平地上给隆起来。那你就会想到，为什么这么平坦的一片地方，有这么高的、这么俊美的一片山？有可能这些山是飞过来的。Even
in Thailand and Malaysia, there you can see some mountains like that.
就像在马来西亚，在泰国也有一些山。
They look like in the past maybe they were flying and they had wings, but the wings got cut off by Indra.
他们也许在之前他们是可以飞的，然后也有翅膀，但是他们的翅膀被 Indra 给砍掉了。
So sometimes these flying mountains are there, and their wings get cut by Indra.
有一些时候，有一些山是可以飞翔的，它们的翅，而且它们也有翅膀，但是它们的翅膀在之后被Indra给砍掉了。But
Vritasura's body was just like such a mountain.
Vritasura的身体这个时候看上去就像这样的一座山。So
Vritasura, he was really strong. He had great strength and power.
Vritasura 非常的强大，而且他有非常强大的力量。
So he placed his lower jaw on the ground, and he had his upper jaw in the sky. So then, you know, he opened his mouth. The lower jaw was on the ground, and the upper jaw was up in the sky.
他张开着嘴，就是Vritasura，他张开着嘴，下颚置于地面，上颚放在天空。
And his mouth became very deep like the sky.
他的口变得非常的深邃，就像天空一样深邃。
And his tongue was like a big snake.
他的舌头好像一头巨蟒。
And his teeth were very fearful looking.
他的牙齿看上去非常的可怕。
It seemed like he was trying to eat the whole universe.
看上去就要吞掉整个宇宙一样。
So like this Vritasura, he'd taken this huge body.
Vritasura拥有这么一个巨大的躯体。
So this body was so big that even the mountains began to shake.
他的躯体如此的巨大，甚至动摇着所有的山脉。
And he was crushing the earth, the surface of the earth with his legs.
他用他的双腿碾压地面。
It was like Vritasura was the Himalayas walking about.
他看上去就像是行走的喜马拉雅山。
And so in this way, Vritasura came before Indra, and he swallowed Indra and Airavrata, the elephant carrier.
Vritasura就这样走到Indra的面前，他于是吞下了Indra和他的坐骑大象Airavata。
Just like a big python might swallow an elephant.
就像一条巨蟒吞噬了一头大象一样。
Yeah, pythons say they have that power that they can crush other living entities. When they swallow them, they will crush them in their bodies.
这个巨蟒就有这样的能力，它能够吞噬其他的生物体。
So pythons sometimes swallow an elephant.
有些时候巨蟒它甚至能够吞噬大象。Okay,
so it seems like Vritasura has won the battle. He's swallowed Indra.
这个时候好像看上去Vritasura赢了这场战斗，他赢了，他把Indra给吃掉了。You
have to wait till next week to hear what happens.
我们下一个星期 再来，你们大家得等一等，我们下个星期再来看这个后面到底会发生什么事情。
So, are there any questions?
Not yet. here have some question. First question from Nilavata. 顶拜孤乳和所有的奉献者，博家梵歌十三点三一要只说灵魂归一。这个灵魂归一英文版写的好像是 The spirit soul is one， 怎么理解？Obeisance to Guru and all devotees in the Bhagavad Gita, chapter 13, verse 31, in the purport, it said, the spirit soul is one. How to understand this?
Spirit soul is one.
The soul is one.
Yes, spirit soul is one.Every individual soul is one spirit soul. Every individual is one spirit soul.
每一个个体的灵魂是一个独立的灵魂。
13th chapter, which verse?
31.
Let me check. Chapter verse 31. When a sensible man ceases to see different identities due to different material bodies, and he sees how beings are expanded everywhere, he attains to the Brahman conception.
In the purport, it said, when the material body is finished, the soul is one.
Where is it? In the purport?
Yes.
After the destruction of the material body, the spirit soul is one. The
yes.
spirit soul, due to contact with material nature, gets different types of bodies. When one can see this, he attains spiritual vision, thus being freed from the differentiation, like man, animal,Yeah, okay. Spirit soul is one. Yeah, you are one spirit soul. I am also one spirit soul. Every living entity is one spirit soul.
你是一个个体的灵魂，他也是一个个体的灵魂，我也是一个个体灵魂，每一个人都是一个个体灵魂。
So spirit soul is one. Of course, we have the super soul accompanying us.That's also one. Super soul is one.
我们还有一个超灵，他和我们在一起。
But he's
这个超灵也是一个。
He's expanded with each and every living entity, accompanying each and every living entity in the material world.
他扩展他自己，进入到每一个的物质，进入到每一个个体生物之内。
Yes.
Next question. Next question from Chaitanya Charan. 顶拜孤类，为什么有些恶魔比奉献者还像奉献者？怎么理解这种现象 ？Obeisance to Guru Dev. Why are some demons are more like devotees than the devotees? How to understand this?
Well, we have to understand that the material position.Our position in the material world does not make us a devotee.
我们要了解的是，这种物质的地位不是让我们
不会让我们成为奉献者。
Just because someone's born in a demigod family or because someone has the position of a demigod, it doesn't mean that he's a great devotee.
就像有一些人他出生在半神人之家，并不意味着他是一个伟大的奉献者。
And at the same time, someone may be born in the demon family or low born, but we shouldn't think that they cannot be devotees. They can also be devotees.
同样，另外一个角度讲，有一些人他虽然出生在恶魔之家，这也并不意味着他不能够成为奉献者，他有可能还是一位伟大的奉献者。
Krishna consciousness is in every living entity.
Krishna 知觉在每一个生物体的心中。
So, sometimes we told, you know, Vritasura was actually a great devotee in his previous life.
在之前 ，Vritasura 前一生他是一个伟大的奉献者。
And actually, what happened was, this cursing was arranged to help him go back to Godhead quicker.
而且这一个诅咒是让他能够回归守神更快一些。
By putting him into that situation in a demon body, it used up all of his bad karma, and then all the bad karma was finished, and can go back to Godhead.
把他处于这样的一种困境之中，这样就能够销毁他所有的不好的恶报。当他的恶报结束了之后，他能够回归守神的。
嗯。So we should never judge a Vaishnava or a devotee by their material birth or their situation in the material world.
因此，我们任何时候都不要通过一个人外在的身份去评价或者判别一位奉献者在这个世界上。
That's offensive to do that.
这实际上是一个冒犯。Next question.
Yes.
Next question from Radhe Sham. 顶拜 Gurudev, 顶拜翻译，顶拜所有的奉献者，请问把恶魔变成奉献者有什么妙招吗？谢谢。Obeisances to Gurudev and all devotees. I want to ask, if we want to transform the demon to the devotees, is there any good ways?
Yes.Good way, give them prasadam. Let them chant Hare Krishna. Give them some books. Give them Prabhupada books. Give them mercy.
给予他们 prasadam, 给予他们让他们唱诵，给予他们圣帕帕德的书，给予圣帕帕德的仁慈。
Get them to do some service for Krishna.
让他们做一些为主 Krishna 的奉献服务。
And then the demons, just like we see, Jagai and Madai, they became devotees. They were big demons, but they became devotees.
就像加盖和马代，他们之前也是非常恶魔，但是他们之后却变成了奉献者。
Lord Nityananda went to them, told them to chant Hare Krishna.
主尼铁南达去到他们那里，告诉他们唱诵 Hare Krishna.
So they got angry at first, and they hit Lord Nityananda.
最开始的时候，他们非常愤怒，而且攻击了主尼铁南达。
But then Lord Chaitanya came. Lord Chaitanya was going to kill them, but Lord Nityananda pleaded to give mercy to them, to save them.
主柴坦亚这个时候就来了，他们主柴坦亚准备杀了他们两个人，但是主尼铁南达阻拦了下来。说请求你，请求你给予他们仁慈。
Lord Chaitanya said, Lord Nityananda told, he said, in this age you must be merciful.
主柴坦亚告哦不，主尼铁南达告诉主柴坦亚说，在这个年代你应该仁慈。
So then, Lord, after they'd hit Lord Nityananda, they felt very bad, so they came and they asked.What could they do to make up for their offense because they've been so offensive by hitting Lord Nityananda? So they asked, what could they do to make up for their offenses? So they were told they could make a ghat at the side of the Ganga, and when people come to take bath, they should serve them.
当加盖和马代攻击了主尼田南达，他们想为他们所做的这种冒犯做一些补救的时候，他就问我们应该做一些什么。主告诉他们，你们可以在冈嘎河，在恒河岸边设立一个点，当人们在那里沐浴完之后，你们可以去服务他们。
And they would fold up their clothes. When people came to take bath, they would fold up their clothes and they would serve them.
当他们做完，当人们去恒河沐浴完之后，去沐浴完之后，你们就可以去服务这些去恒河沐浴的人。
And in this way, they got the blessings of the devotees. And in this way, they became great devotees.
通过这样的方式，你们可以服务奉献者，然后你们可以成为伟大的奉献者。
Okay.
Next question from Vrindavan Das. Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Gurudev 和所有的奉献者的莲花族，请问从事什么样的奉献服务？去到外昆塔从事什么样的服务去到格罗卡 Hare Krishna, basis to Gurudev and all the devotees, I want to ask, what kind of devotional service if we do, then we go to the外昆塔 and what kind of service, then we can go to the格罗卡
Yes, it depends on the particular relationship which you are cultivating with Krishna.
是的这个是取决于你在你在培养的是哪一种和 Krishna 特定的心态或者特定的关系。
If you're attracted to the opulence of Krishna and you like to serve Krishna, you see Krishna like a king and you like to see Krishna with opulence, then and you'll see Krishna also with his wives, and then you would go to Dwarka or you go to Vaikuntha.
如果你非常受 Krishna 的外在的富裕所吸引，非常希望 Krishna 有一种富裕的打扮，而且和他的妻子在一起，你希望这一切都富丽堂皇的，很好的被打扮，那你可能会去到 Vaikuntha。
But if you go to Goloka, you have to see Krishna as the son of Nanda Maharaj, and worship Krishna, think of Krishna as a cowherd boy.And you're attracted to the countryside life and to be in the countryside with the cows and go to the forest and play with all the cowherd boys and all the cows.
如果你是被 Krishna, 他作为 Nanda Maharaj 的儿子所吸引 Krishna 他是一个牧牛童他和他的牧牛童在一起而且喜欢这种乡村的生活喜欢 Krishna, 牧牛和奶牛在一起，那么你将会去到 Goloka。
So in Vaikuntha, there's more awe and reverence for Krishna, and so you don't get so intimate with Krishna.
在 Vaikuntha 是sorry, Gurudev, Raven.
Awe and reverence, Junjong, you give more respect, you know.
Okay. 在这个外昆塔，你和 Krishna 是更多的是一种敬畏的心态，尊重的心态。
Because Krishna is the king and he's sitting on the throne and he's above you and everyone's bowing to him.
因为 Krishna 是那里的国王，他坐在皇位上，所有人向他顶拜。
But in Vrindavan, Krishna's a cowherd boy, and he's playing, he has his cowherd boy friends, and he has the gopis, and it's very intimate and dealing. It's a very different mood from Vaikuntha.
而在 Vrindavan, 主 Krishna 是一个牧牛童，他和牧牛童在这种玩耍的这种心态。
So, in the countryside, like Vrindavan,You know, there's more friendship there with the people. It's more relaxed atmosphere, and people are very close to each other, and they have great love for each other.
在这种乡村，主 Krishna 在这种乡村的生活，他们是有更多的亲近的关系，有更多的友谊的关系，相互之间有更多的爱的这种关系。
But of course, it's not as opulent as Vaikuntha.
当然，这种乡村生活并没有Vaikuntha那么富裕。
But in Vaikuntha, because there's so much opulence, there's not so much friendship. People are not so close to each other, and they can't get so close to Krishna.
而在 Vaikuntha, 人们由于富裕，非常的富裕，而且是这种关系，他们并没有像乡村生活中那么多的友谊，那么多的亲近的这种关系。
And usually in Vaikuntha, people worship Lakshmi Narayan. They worship the Lord in his forearm form as Narayan.
而在外昆塔，通常人们崇拜的是 Lakshmi Narayana 这个形象。Narayana 的这个 Lakshmi Narayana 的这个形象是四臂的这个形象。
But in Goloka it's Krishna.
然而在 Goloka 是 Krishna 两臂的形象。
Yeah, Shyamasundar Krishna.
Shyamasundar Krishna.
Yeah? 还有问题吗
？Yeah.Next question from Sitarani. 顶拜孤乳，周一到周五城市生活，周末农村生活，被吸引到哪里去啊？这个问题好。Sitarani, 您能不能再说一下您这个问题？这个最后一句话。哦、oh, ，OK, OK, I understand.Hare Krishna, good day. A basic to good day. If Monday to Friday is the city life, and the Sunday and the Saturday are the countryside life, so what kind of, if this kind of life, where we will go?
Well, it depends on your mood. What mood are you cultivating to Krishna?
这个取决于你的心态，你到底培养的是和 Krishna 的哪一种心态？这个取决于你自己。
You may be in the countryside, but you may be more in the mood of Vaikuntha.
你或许在乡村的生活，但是你的心里可能想的是 Vaikuntha 的这种感觉。
Because if your mood is just to be the servant, and you're not very intimate or you're not very close to Krishna.Then you'd be more likely to go to Vaikuntha.
如果你只是想成为一个仆人，而并不是说想和 Krishna 特别亲近的这种关系，你可能会去到的是 Vaikuntha.
But if you're cultivating a nice, friendly relationship, maybe even a gopi relationship or a parental relationship, you're thinking of Krishna like your child.Then it's different, you know. That it depends on the mood which you have, not the place where you are, but the mood you in which you serve Krishna.
这个不取决于我们在什么样的地方去服务 Krishna, 而是取决于我们的心态是什么。比如说，我们想更多的是成为 Krishna 的朋友，或者说勾皮姑娘、木流姑娘这样，或者说 Krishna 的父母之情的这种爱。我们有可能去到的是 Goloka.
So, Sitarani, you can take Krishna for your son. Because you have two daughters, you don't have a son. So you can take Krishna for your son. And when you're offering, you can speak to Krishna like he's your son.
所以 Sitarani Mataji, 你可以把 Krishna 当作你的儿子。你已经有两个女儿了，但是你没有儿子。你可以老想着 Krishna 作为你的儿子，你在供奉的时候想着是你为你的亲爱的儿子做服务。
And when you wake the deities up in the morning, you can speak to him, "Come on, Krishna, my little boy, it's time for you to wake up. You have to get up now."
当你早上唤醒 Krishna 起床的时候，你可以向你的神像说，哦，我亲爱的小 Krishna, 请你起来吧，已经到起床的时间了。
And in the evening, you can tell Krishna, "All right, Krishna, now it's bedtime. It's time for you to take your rest. Be a good boy. Go to bed."
到晚上的时候，你可以跟 Krishna 说：“哦，亲爱的 Krishna， 现在已经到晚上睡觉的点了，做一个好孩子吧，也该睡觉了。”
So cultivate the mood. Take Krishna for your child, or you may like to have some other relationship. I don't know.
所以培养一种好的心态，和 Krishna 发展一种友谊，或者说其他的心态，我并不知道的这样的一种和 Krishna 特定的关系。
You may like to have a conjugal relationship.
或者你和 Krishna 有那种更亲密的爱人的关系。
All right. Any other questions?
Yeah. Next question from Madhu Kanti Devidasi. 亲爱的 Gurudev, 如何理解 Purusha 和 Dirty 这两个 Dirty 这两个词呢？ Purusham 享乐者是指个体灵魂吗？ Dirty 被翻译成决心，但决心就分了三种决心，有一点难理解。My dear Gurudev, how to understand the Purusham and the Dirty, these two words?
Purusham.
Yeah.
Govinda Madhi Purusham, Tamaham Bhajamin.
Yeah, Purusham. And the other word is D-H-R-T-Y.
R-T-A.
Y. R-T-Y. D-H-R-T-Y.
Dritti, yeah. There's no Y. I never saw that word. D-H-R-T-Y.
Yeah, I also didn't know this word.
There should be a vowel there.
Where is it? Where is it? She said this word translated to be determination.
Determination. Dridavrat. Dridavrat. It's there in the Bhagavad Gita. Dridavrat. Determination.Yes. What does she want to know?
She wants to know Purusha. How to understand Purusha? Purusha means the living entity.
Yes, certainly has to be a living entity. But it could be Krishna. Krishna is actually the supreme Purush. Purusha means the enjoyer. So he is the supreme enjoyer.
Purusham 也可以指个体灵魂，也可以指至尊灵魂。至尊灵魂它是至尊的享受者。
Yes, Krishna is the original supreme enjoyer, so he is but the living entity, we are also Purushas, because we try to enjoy the material world.
个体灵魂也是享受者，因为我们在试图享受这个物质世界。
And in the Hindi language, Purusha means male, means man.
在印度的语系之中 ，Purusha 被解释为 male， 就是男性。
Because people are all thinking, you know, to enjoy the material world. We're thinking we're the Purusha. Actually, we're not the Purusha.We're meant to be enjoyed by Krishna. Krishna is the real Purusha.
但是事实上，表面上我们是想享受这个物质世界。This dritti, translate to be determination. There are three kinds of determination, how to understand.
It means in the different modes. Determination in the mode of ignorance, in the mode of passion, and then in the mode of goodness.
三种决心的意思就是三种不同心态的决心，有激情心态的决心，愚昧心态的决心，和善良属性的决心。
Right. Determination. I can't remember exactly how they're described, but if you look in the, I think it's in the 18th chapter, then determination is described there. Or maybe it's the 17th chapter. Either the 17th or 18th chapter, you will see there's a description of the three different kinds of determination.
在《薄伽梵歌》的第17章或者第18章描述了三种不同类型的决心。
Yeah, will I find it for you? Let me look here. Determination. Just give me a minute.
姑姑现在找一找，您稍微等一下。
Okay, yeah, determination. 1833 to 1835.
在第十八章的33章节到35章节。
Yes. Describe that determination which is unbreakable, which is sustained with steadfastness by yoga practice, and which thus controls the activities of the mind, life, and senses, is determination in the mode of goodness.
佛家梵歌第十八章的33章节，通过瑜伽修习，使决心坚定，百折不挠，控制心意、生命、感官和活动，这样的决心在善良属性之中。
Then text 34, that determination by which one holds fast to fruitive results in religion, economic development, and sense gratification is of the nature of passion.
34章节，牢牢抓住宗教经济发展的成果，执着于感官满足，这样的决心在激情形态之中。
And that determination which cannot go beyond dreaming, fearfulness, lamentation, moroseness, and illusion, such unintelligent determination is in the mode of darkness.
而不能跨出迷梦、恐惧、哀伤、抑郁以及假象的决心。这样的决心在愚昧形态之中。
Okay, so those are the three kinds of determination.
这就是三种决心。Next question.
Yes.
Next question from 珍珍。Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Guru Maharaj 的莲花组，顶拜所有的奉献者，请问 Guru Maharaj, Guru, 一，去到奉献者的家里的时候，怎么服务奉献者？冒犯的意思就是二，冒犯的意思就是让别人觉得不舒服吗？还是别人生气就是冒犯呢？有的时候不知道是不是冒犯了别人，当自己痛苦的时候就在想，我是不是冒犯的导致自己痛苦？怎么样面对这个呢 ？Hare Krishna, basin to Guru Maharaj and the lotus feet. When we go to the devotee's home, how to serve the devotees?
Well.You should talk about Krishna.
你应该去讲述 Krishna.
When you go to devotee's homes, you can inquire, you can ask some questions about Krishna, or you can share your realizations about Krishna.
你可以向他们询问有关于 Krishna 的话题，或者向他们分享你了解的主 Krishna.
You may like to do kirtan with them.
你或者也可以和他们一起做唱诵。
You may like to cook for them. You may like to bring some food there for them, bring prasadam for them and share it with them.
或者你带一些普沙丹过去和他们一起做饭。
嗯。
And the second question she asked, what's the meaning of the offense? Is that means we make others uncomfortable or we make others angry?
Offense means if you criticize someone on the basis of their birth, if you criticize someone, you know, on the basis of their birth or on the basis of some past what they did before they became devotees, then, or if you criticize them for some improper reason, then that is considered offense.
冒犯的意思是意味着你批评他们的出身以及他们过往的，就是说在他们成为奉献者之前的这种过往的这种行为，这是冒犯，或者说，OK。
If somebody may have some problem, they may have maybe a little fall down, maybe they did something wrong. So if you criticize them for that, you know, maybe they did something unintentionally, and if you criticize them, that's an offense.
如果有一些人他做了一些事情，并不是有意去做了这样的一件事情，但是你去批评他的话，这是一种冒犯。Sometimes I didn't know whether I offend others. So when I feel very pain and distress, I think, what kind of offense? Maybe I offend the others. So make me very painful. So how to face this kind of condition?
Well, instead of offending people, you should see good in them and praise them and appreciate them. Say something nice to them. Don't criticize people.
为了避免去冒犯别人，你尽量的去看别人的优点，去表扬别人，去赞美别人。
Okay.
Okay. Next question from Sugita Sangha Mataji.顶拜孤乳外观他的居民没有年龄的差距吗？感恩你，感恩翻译。Obeisance to Guru. In the Vaikuntha, the residents of the Vaikuntha, there are no difference between each other?
Yes, that's what we hear.
是的，他们没有年龄差距，这就是我们听到的。Then she asked, if no difference of the age,between each other, how become a mother and a son?
Yeah. I don't know everything. I don't know all the details. You'll find out when you go there.
我也不知道所有的这些细节。当你去到那的时候，你去发现这个事情。
Usually we hear everyone's the same age. So there's no mothers and no sons. There's just all devotees.
通常情况下是没有年龄的差距，所有人都是母亲，所有人都是儿子，所有人都是奉献者。
You have to understand in Vaikuntha, there's the mood there is everyone's a servant of Krishna, and Krishna's the master, so everyone else is a servant.
在比如说在 Vaikuntha, 所有人都是仆人，所有人。主 Krishna 是主人，所有人都是主 Krishna 的仆人。
So everyone's like friends with each other, and they're all servants of Krishna.
所有人都像朋友一样，就是他们之间是朋友，但是他们都一起服务主 Krishna.
They're all devoted servants.
他们都是奉献者仆人。
Just like if you join Krishna consciousness.In the 1960s and 70s, everyone was young. You know, all the devotees were young. There were no old people.
就像在1960年代、70年代的时候，那些时候人们加入 Krishna 知觉，那个时候加入 Krishna 知觉的所有人都是年轻人。
So, you know, there were no mothers, no fathers.
没有父亲，没有母亲。
And in the spiritual world, nobody gets old. Nobody grows old. So you don't need mothers and fathers.
在灵性世界，没有人会变老，所以没有没也没有父亲和母亲的这个概念。没有父亲和母亲。
And sometimes new people come. They come back from the material world. They come back to the spiritual world.
有些时候，有些新人来，他们来有，他们来，他们重新返回这个灵性世界。
And usually they're all grihasthas. They're all usually in householder ashram.
而且通常他们都是处在居士，都是居士的阿舍。
Okay.
Okay. Here is the last question. I think. 加一个温达玛的经，顶拜亲爱的姑姑和翻译。今天利用周天休息的时间，第一次尝试一个人背着双肩包去附近的大学派书。马路上站了两个多小时，一本也没派出去，心里有一点气馁。观察路过的人都是行色匆匆，热情地向他们打招呼、介绍书籍，被拒绝无数次。感觉在中国以这样的方式派书，并不很受欢迎。越是热情，对方越跑得快，除非是免费送。希望再次得到guru的祝福，让我能够找到好的派书方法。顶拜您的莲花座。Obeisances to Guru and all deep. understand?
Go ahead, translate.
Okay. Today I use the rest time because Sunday and Sunday use this rest time. First time try to go outside with my bag near the university. I preach, distribute a book near the university.In the road, I stand 2 hours in the on the road, but no books distribute. I have some distress. I watch them. Everyone are very busy with their work. I'm enthusiasm to say hello to them, but they don't care about me and refuse me many times. I feel in China.If we distribute the books in this way, I think are not welcome. The more we enthusiasm, the more fast they go away. Except we give the books for free, then they will accept it. Otherwise, they will not accept it. So I want to receive your blessings again. Let me find another good ways to distribute the books. Obeisances to your Lord's feet, Hare Krishna.
Yes, you're right. You have to find another way to distribute books.
是的，你应该找到更好的其他的方式去派书。
You should also understand that probably at this time at the university, they're very close to the end of the semester, so they're in the middle of their exams.
你也应该知道，在这个时候的大学，他们都在准备着他们的期末考试。
And so when they're in exam time, it's not a good time to try to distribute your book there.
所以在期末考试的时候，可能不是一个向他们派书的很好的时机。
Yeah, you have to pick the right time to get them.
所以你要找一个好的时机去向他们去传。
And with students, you have to understand students are not so wealthy people.
你也要知道那些学生不是说特别有钱的人。
So if you can give the books, you know, you can probably give a lot of books there to people.
如果你能免费的给予他们很多书籍，也是很好。
So you have to try to get some people to sponsor books, and then you can come and give out the books to the students.
如果你要给予他们书籍的话，你就得找一些人去赞助你做这样的事情，这样你就可以免费派发他们一些书籍。
But, students are a good potential to read the book. That they, you know, they're people who will read.
学生是一个非常有潜力的团体，他们会很好的去阅读这些书籍。
Other people, you don't know how much they read, but students, at least, you know, they read. They'll have that's their occupation.
其他的人我不知道，我们不太了解他们会不会读这些书，但是学生他们的职业就是去读书。
So if you can, in the future, if you get somebody who's got a lot of books they want to give out free, then you can arrange to give them out there.
所以如果有人，你发现有人他在捐书的话，你就收集一些这样的免费的书籍，你就寻求他们的帮忙，捐给你一些书，这样你就免费向他们派发一些书。
Some people give out books free to people, and people are not very good candidates to read.
有一些人，如果我们免费派发给书的话，他们却并不是这种会读书的人。
Anyway, it's, you know, you tried, that's very good, you know, Krishna's pleased with you, you made an effort to go out there and you tried to approach people, so that's very pleasing to Krishna, just the fact that you made the effort to do that.
不管怎么样，你今天做出这样的努力， Krishna 是会很欣赏，很被取悦的，因为你去做的努力，去到外面去派书，去为了主 Krishna。
Don't be attached to the results.
不要太在意这个结果。
No, you made the effort. That was good. That's the important thing. Krishna is pleased by your effort.
你做出努力，这就是很好的。Krishna 会被你的努力所取悦。
And by making that effort.You know, you became more Krishna conscious. You were thinking of Krishna.
通过做出这样的努力，你会更多的去想着 Krishna.
And so I'm really also appreciating you that you made that effort. Thank you very much that you went out there and tried to distribute books. I'm very pleased that you did that.
我也很欣赏你的这种活动，我非常被你的这种活动所取悦。你能够去到外面去向他们去派书，非常好。
And don't be disappointed.
不要沮丧。
Sometimes we get results and sometimes we don't.
有一些时候我们能得到结果，有些时候我们得不到结果。
Yeah, we're not the doers. We're just the instrument.
我们不是作为者，我们只是一个工具而已。There one Mataji named Chen Meili. She said, "I can donate the books."
Oh, so she can contact Govinda, Jai Govinda Mataji, and Jai Govinda can give out the books.
Chen Meili Mataji, you can contact Jai Govinda Mataji, and then the books can be donated to him.Here have one more question from Krishna Kumari, Dibai Guru. 请问多帕提出生时，天上声音叫他 Krishna， 这有什么声音 ？Obeisance to Guru. When the Dwapati birth, there one sound from the heaven said Krishna. What's the meaning?
It means.Is very dear to Krishna.
这个意味着他对 Krishna 来说很亲切。Okay. No more question.
Okay.
So
when woman, Fichan Ganshya Suburi Rai, Prabhu Giva Mpani, woman Ganshya Soido Functions of Ling Ting.And T1, and Woman Jufu Niman, Chuan Jiao Shun Li, Wan Shit Rui, Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai.
Jai.
Go back to Vrinda Ki.
Jai.
Oh, Woman Yaganshya Sati Mataji Jujur. Om Gan Shri Sayodaya Pangshi Anja. Hare Krishna.